You're one of the former Yankees with a fun Instagram feed. Are you ready to check it out?
I'm ready to check it out.
Let's do it.
Let's see.
First one, doing a little hiking.
That was it in Malibu, California last year. I went on a 7-day detox retreat type thing, and 12 miles of hiking a day, 1,400 calories a meal a day, and it was a great experience.
That sounds like a very healthy trip.
With a group of strangers. I never met these people before in my life, so it was just 16 of us and hiking, breakfast, lunch, and dinner together.
Amazing. So what did you take most out of that trip then?
What I took out of that trip was how we ate 1,400 calories a day of vegan food and didn't realize I could really survive on that little amount of food. And it just goes to show how much I really overeat on a daily basis.
How much weight did you lose?
I lost 12 pounds in 7 days in that retreat. We walked 12 miles a day. We had 2 one-hour workouts, so 2 hours total, a massage and yoga every day.
Wow, amazing. And there you are again doing a little more.
That's one of my friends I met on the trip. That guy's about to get married. He's from New York. He's a big Yankee fan, so we kind of hung out a little bit. Had a great time.
You also like to hit the links a lot. Here's a couple of cool photos of you going golfing.
Yeah.
Where are some of your favorite spots that you've golfed so far?
Well, those three you just passed through. The first one was Oakmont in Pittsburgh. It's one of the top ranked courses in America. They play a PGA event there, and it's a really hard golf course. And these guys won an event at an auction, and I was included in the auction, so I got to go on that trip. That one there is Augusta National. That was like a bucket list for me. Friends of mine in New York again called me last year and asked if I wanted to play 2 days there. Stanley O'Neill, these guys, I really appreciate that. I'll never forget it. That was at Derek Jeter's golf event last year in Las Vegas, Shadow Creek, and that's Tanyan Sturts, Brandy Chastain, the soccer superstar, and Jorge Posada, Yankee legend.
Talk about a foursome.
It's a great time. That was down in Puerto Rico last August, Posada's charity event to raise money for the hurricane relief in Puerto Rico.
Here you are, Tampa Bay Lightning game.
That's me, the Tampa Bay Lightning game with the legendary Pat Sajak. I didn't know him, he just happened to be sitting right next to me at the game, and we had a great time and some great conversation. That is a local daytime show here in Tampa. A friend of mine, Jackie Rodriguez, they asked me to host the show a couple times here and there, so I went on it and did it for an hour in the morning, and it's another good experience.
Did your time with Pat Sajak help you with the hosting gig?
Not at all.
Here you are, Tampa Legends.
Yeah, that's a Tom Shannon, the legendary Lou Piniella. I was out to dinner one night here in Tampa and just happened to run across him. Wound up sitting with Lou Piniella and going over some old times about playing for him in the Seattle Mariner days and his career with the Yankees. So he's always great to catch up with and a close friend of mine.
Do you guys bump into each other a lot? Because I know you're both Tampanos.
Yes, Tampanos are the Latin group of people that grew up in West Tampa. That's where we came from. And Lou Piniella's from there. My parents are from there as well.
And you also get some first pitches thrown in. Here you are with Fred McGriff.
Well, Fred McGriff and I actually played at the same time in 2004. They asked us to throw out the first pitch to commemorate a local player that played for the Rays here in Tampa.
And?
That's last 4th of July, you know, we always go out to down Longboat Key in Sarasota and have a great time, my brothers and I and all of our families.
Beautiful water around here, so it's nice that you take advantage of it. And awesome. I see why you haven't left.
Yep, I take advantage of it quite a bit.
Last one, here you are, Giancarlo Stanton.
Yep, that was last year, I'll never forget it. Last year in spring training, his first year here. Just talking to him, you know, just catching up with him, see how he's feeling out here, getting accustomed to the Yankees, the new team, the new surroundings, just trying to make him feel comfortable because he's a great player and he's gonna be a great player for us for a long time.
We see all these fun posts that you have. What's your favorite part about Instagram?
Well, you know, my fun part is the people I meet and the posts I put and the comments I get. It's really cool to see you with Jorge Posada or so-and-so and whatnot, but also the people I do follow and see what they're doing as well. It's kind of interesting to see where everybody's at.
All right, so here's the time for the plug. Watch somebody follow you and what do you have to offer?
Well, I'm not that funny, but I do try
to... Nah, don't do that.
I go to interesting places and I try to post the people I'm with mainly. You know, it's not really all about me, but who I'm with and what adventures we happen to be on.